I believe in God and prayer and surrounding our Lord Jesus, surrounding our children with that precious blood of our Lord. You know? We can't do anything without prayer. We need that in a child's life. We have prayer, we have hope, but we have faith that things will go well for them. It gives you courage to keep going on, to keep never losing hope that things won't get better. So for 2018, surround your children with prayer and everything else will fall in line.
Okay. So if you had one piece of advice for new for mothers in the whole, what would it be?
I said, darling, the best way to live is to put your trust in God, but to put your trust in man, you're failing. God is the boss. Always.
Thank you.
He never fails you. Just put your trust in God and everything will work. Have a nice day.
Stop being hard on yourself. Fix yourself sometimes. Sometimes you have to give yourself a reassurance. Watch in the mirror when you're bathing. Just watch yourself and tell yourself that you're doing good because your children still growing. They're growing. You're still doing things for them. You mightn't be able to give them the lavish things, but just simply providing food on a daily basis, sending them to school, being there for them, loving them. That's all it takes sometimes. Stop being hard on yourself. Stop being hard on yourself. Give yourself a little break sometimes. Parents need to cool the mind a little bit too. Because if your mind all confuffled, it will make things hard. So just give yourself a break. Reassure yourself that you're doing the best you could and everything will be all right, in my opinion.
Very nice.
To live and let live, even though you know the children make a mistake, don't be down on them. Yes, they made a mistake, the mistake was already made. It's how you move on from there is what matters. That's my advice. And if you treat it like that, I think everything will be successful.
Try to be a child's biggest cheerleader. Encourage them, even though if they feel at something, don't let them say they get a D or they get an R and make them feel less of themselves. Always try to encourage them. Learn about your children. Learn your children because every child has a different personality and success comes within. Let them know, okay, you are blessed. You are highly favored. Encourage them, words of encouragement, because if a child feels less than, you know, you're always dunging on them. That is the number one thing of, does a child be successful or not, you know? So be a child's biggest cheerleader, encourage. Practice, 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 make perfect. Always be there, even though if you're not a parent who mentally may not all right, education wise, even though if you're not education wise to help your child, just being there as a parent. If you are a working parent, just, you know, simple little notes, take a little notes for your child, making sure and ensuring that your child knows that you are there and you care. Asking little questions, even though you might be cooking or you might be busy, you know, never be too busy for your child. Still ask little questions, you know, how was your day at school, you know? Children need to feel important, and important is ensure a child's self-esteem, build a child's self-esteem, and you will guarantee to be success.
First of all, I would like to tell the
parents to have God within all the endeavors that they do with their children. That's one. Two, push them. Let them know that the sky is the limit. Don't stop, and no matter whatever it is they're doing. And we as parents, we have to be there for our children, no matter where it is. Either single parent or being on both parents together, let them know that they have to be there for the child.
If you had to give advice to mothers for their children to be successful, for themselves and their children to be successful in 2018, what would it be?
Listen to your children more and what they want to do, and push them to do what they want to do. That's their passion.
Awesome. Thank you.
Hello everybody. I have been trying to film this video for the last 2 days. I could not get it done. It just wasn't working out. And there's so many things that I wanted to see. So what I did is, I got a little help from my friends. What I did is, I walked down the street in Port of Spain. I spoke to different people and I will insert their answers. And this is my intro. So, the 2 cents I want to add is this. Mothers, you need to take care of yourself first. It is the only way you will know how to take care of anybody else. It is the only way you will be able to take care of anybody else. And we need to relax. Trust yourself that you're doing a good job, or at least the best job that you could do. I know it often feels like when a decision isn't made or the best results aren't garnered from a decision you have made, that the world is coming to an end. It really isn't. It really isn't. But I understand. But if we are too hard on ourselves, then we can never ever do the best for our children. We can't even do the best for ourselves. So for 2018, take care of yourself. Take care of your children. Pray to whatever God you have. As you will see, my friends would have said so. Trust yourself. And then find time to relax.